So, explaining the problem and background information.
So, what is bocce ball? Bocce ball is one of the world's oldest sports played with eight large bocce balls and one small target ball called pallino. The teams take turns throwing the ball and attempt to get closer to the pallino. And bocce ball is part of the ACPS Special Olympics. It's also
part of the Special Olympics Unified Sports Program, where disabled athletes compete alongside non-disabled athletes.
Because of the weight of the ball, the students in the hotel often use ramps to help them play the sport. However, the equipment in ACPS sport programs were not and is inadequate.
So in the U.S., in the world, 15% of the world's population is disabled. In the U.S., 48.9 million people have a disability. Thank you. and 6.4 million of those people are students. The four most prevalent disability categories in public schools today are specific learning disabilities, speech and language impairment, other health impairments, and autism. So sports are an important aspect of many people's lives. They provide both physical and social benefits. Among the physical benefits are the decreased risk for a childhood obesity, which can cause later problems in life. And among the social benefits are improved social and socialization and communication skills.
So despite the many benefits offered by sports, disabled students participate in sports at much lower rates than their non-disabled counterparts. Studies have found that disabled students are 4.5 times less active than their non-disabled counterparts. As seen on the screen, disabled children participate in sports at much lower rates than their non-disabled counterparts. This is, of course, a huge problem because they are not afforded the benefits offered by sports that those without disabilities are. This is what we hope to achieve with our product. Many people cite specialized equipment as a problem regarding their participation. So there have been many attempts to legislate equal access, both within the federal government and within the state government. In the early history of the U.S., disabled students were often excluded from the public school system. This changed in 1973 with the passage of the Rehabilitation Act. This act mandates that all students be provided with an education, and in Section 504 states that every student within the U.S. must be provided with a free and appropriate public education. Next was the Americans with Disability Act, passed in 1990. This act prohibits discrimination on the basis of disability in all aspects of public life and provides a federal definition for disability. Next is the Individuals with Disability Education Act. This act provides funding for special education programs and requires that each student receive an individualized education plan, which includes such things as extracurricular opportunities and sports. In an attempt to legislate the responsibilities of county school systems in providing equal access in sports, many states have come up with individualized legislation. Maryland is a leader in this field with the passage of its 2008 Maryland Fitness and Athletic Equity Law for Students with Disabilities. This law requires that all school boards within the state of Maryland provide sports opportunities for those students with disabilities and has spawned the growth of a unified sports program whereby students with disabilities compete alongside students without disabilities. This has, of course, been a huge part of this county's athletic program.
So to summarize our problem, school boards are federally mandated to provide equal access to school sports programs for all students. This has prompted the establishment of the AACPS Unified Sports Program. However, issues persist for students in wheelchairs as they continue to lack proper equipment in order to participate in the sport of bocce ball.
Now we walk you through our solution to our problem and the process to develop it.
So in order to meet the needs of wheelchair-bound students, the proposed device must be able to roll the ball at 20 to 30 feet, be easily transportable, and the student must be able to control the speed and distance at which the ball rolls.
this problem is not a new one. There have been several previous attempts to solve it. Among these is a project by a senior capstone team at the California State Polytechnic University in San Luis Obispo, as you can see here. Their device is essentially a catapult, which launches the bocce ball into the air with the press of a button. However, this device does not fulfill the needs of Anne Arundel County Public School students. Because the Unified Sports Program is an affiliate of the Special Olympics, they require that the ball not be propelled by anything. Therefore, as this device propels the ball through the air and is extremely expensive and complicated to build, this is not suitable for students in Anne Arundel County. Here you can see the current device used by students within Anne Arundel County. As you can see, it is extremely bulky and hard to transport, which makes it extremely difficult to bring it to away games, which is a part of the Unified Sports Program in which students are not able to use this ramp. Thus, you can see that all prior solutions are inadequate and a new device must be developed. So what did we do? We built a 7-foot-long PVC ramp with a series of gates down its length, as shown here. The student can select the height at which they want the ball to release, and this thus controls the distance the ball will roll, thus allowing the students to fully participate in the game. The gates are released with the press of a button, thus allowing it to be accessible to a variety of disabilities. The entire thing is connected to a base made out of PVC and wood and plywood, which can easily rotate due to it being on Lazy Susan bearings. This entire thing, as seen here, can come apart, thus aiding to the transportability of the device.
Here's a sketch of our design drawn by Hannah Porter.
So in order to create the best device possible, we created a series of prototypes in order to test concepts. This prototype tests the electronic integration of the raising of the gate. We will now show you a short video demonstrating it. So, in order to create the best device possible, we performed a series of experiments to test the length at which the ramp had to be and the angle in order to create the best device possible. We determined that the best length would be around 7 feet and the ideal angle to be around 30 degrees.
To further explore our prototype, we built a second design showing these pictures, and I will share a brief video of it.
Cost was an important consideration in the design of our product, along with the quality of the materials. The materials we found were mostly online, so we were able to collect the URLs so that people could easily recreate the device in the future. The final cost of the product was $138.
So to conclude our presentation, we really want to share with you the overarching theme, which is equality of access. It is extremely important that all students with disability be able to experience the same opportunities as those students without disability, and this is what we hope to accomplish with our device. So one last message. Disability does not mean inability, and what we hope to achieve with our device is to allow one student that hadn't been able to participate in something they wanted to finally do that.
Yeah, our sources.
It's gonna pull up the website. Press the arrow. Oh,
thank you for your time. Does anyone have any questions?
And we'd also, if you want, you guys can
try
our device. Yes.
Great.